केंद्र सरकार में वरिष्ठ मंत्री श्री तवरचंद गहलोत जी, दीनदयाल जी संशोधन संस्था का महामंत्री श्री अतुल जैन जी, आज का इस कार्यक्रम में उपस्थित सभी देवी और सज्जनों, दीनदयाल शोध संस्था द्वारा आदरणीय नानाजी देशमुख की पुण्य स्मृति में आयोजित व्याख्यान में उपस्थित विद्वत समाज के साथ भारत की समावेश विकास गाथाओं में समाज की बृहत्तर भूमिका जैसे गंभीर विषय पर मुझे अपने विचार साझा करने का अवसर मिला है। इस अवसर के लिए मैं दीनदयाल शोध संस्थान का हृदयपूर्वक आभार व्यक्त करता हूं। I deem it an honor and a privilege to deliver the 8th Nanaji Memorial Lecture. Sri Nanaji Deshmukh is one of the illustrious sons and icons of the modern India, who has inspired and continue to inspire millions of Indians to dedicate themselves to the nation building. One of these millions is myself. He was a unique individual who placed the interest of the country above everything else. Prime Minister Sri Narendra Bhai Modi ji ne kaha, said his commitment and dedication to nation building was unparalleled and described him as a paragon of simplicity. Nanaji faced hardships during his childhood, and his zeal for education made him to sell vegetables and raise money to realize his objective. This struggle and urge to bring light into the lives of people in rural areas inspired him to take up social work. He was truly a Rajarshi in politics, a social activist for excellence, and a man of deeds, not merely words. His work continues to be an inspiration to hundreds of people across the country even today. I was closely associated with him and will always remain as an ardent admirer of his social philosophy. As he used to say, quote, "My life is not for me, but for others." And who are the others? They are the oppressed and depressed and neglected sections of our society. आदरणीय नानाजी ने 1968 में अपने सहयोगी पंडित दीनदयाल उपाध्याय जी का पुण्य स्मृति में दीनदयाल शोध संस्थान की स्थापना की। संस्थान दीनदयाल जी के अंत्योदय, ग्रामोदय जैसा संकल्पों को सिद्ध करने की दिशा में प्रयासरत है। मैं अपने लिए नहीं, अपनों के लिए हूं। आपने वे है जो पीड़ित और उपेक्षित है। नानाजी का यह दर्शन ही संस्था का आदर्श वाक्य, व्हाट यू कॉल इट, मोटो। Nanaji believed and demonstrated through his actions and programs in Chitrakoot that a self-reliant nation cannot be built unless each individual is empowered to contribute to it. He believed in active participation of the people in an integrated and holistic development of the country in all sectors, including health, education, and agriculture. He did not allow this to remain an ideal, dream, or an ideal. He has both a visionary philosopher and a missionary organizer zeal all rolled into one. He had successfully implemented Pandit Deendal Upadhyayji's concept of integral humanism at the grassroots level and founded Deendayal Research Institute in 1968 to give shape to his conceptualization for development of rural India. आप लोगों को याद होगा, महात्मा गांधी जी ने आजादी के बाद दो सलाह दिया। एक सलाह थोड़ा राजनीतिक है, उसमें मैं ज्यादा जाना नहीं चाहता हूं। उन्होंने कहा आजादी मिल गया, आजादी के लिए सब लोग एक साथ आके एक प्लेटफॉर्म में जोड़ के सबने मिलकर आजादी के लिए लड़ाई लड़ा, उसका नाम था कांग्रेस। कांग्रेस वॉज ए प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर स्ट्रगल अगेंस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस। So Gandhiji said, now that we have achieved independence, let us dissolve Congress. What happened subsequently, I don't want to explain. The second advice given by Mahatma Gandhi was back to villages. Move towards the villages because India lives mostly in villages. But unfortunately, our leaders have shown their back to villages, all of us, and then moved towards towns. The result, now there is an urban-rural divide. Dear sisters and brothers, we have given ourselves a great constitution with a preamble in which we have solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all citizens justice, liberty, equality and fraternity. Of course, this secularism and all were subsequently added. Because India is a secular country. Secularism is safe and secure in India not because of any individual, not because of any political party, not because simply constitution alone. It is safe and secure because secularism is in the DNA of all Indians. This has to be understood by one and all. People may claim and people may also argue secularism was more safe under us, less safer under you, etc. Secularism is safe because it is the DNA of all Bharatiyas. We envisaged a democratic future for the country in which we, the people, are at the center. We have been collectively working together to deepen roots of democracy. Our ancient Indian thought is underpinned by humanism, pluralism, and spiritualism. These are the strengths of our Indian civilization. This has been underscored by numerous later-day thought leaders as well. At the center of this worldview has been the belief that human empowerment is key and individual development in all dimensions and an integrated manner is central to progress as a society and as a nation. Behno aur bhaiyo, aap jante hai ki swadhin Bharat ka संविधान समाज के समावेश विकास का दस्तावेज है. संविधान सभा में नया संविधान का प्रारूप प्रस्तुत करते हुए डॉक्टर अंबेडकर जी ने कहा, समाज के समक्ष आने वाले विरोधाभासों पर चिंता जाहिर की थी. उन्होंने कहा था, आई कोट, ऑन द 26th of January 1950, वी आर गोइंग टू एंटर इंटू अ लाइफ ऑफ कॉन्ट्रडिक्शंस. इन पॉलिटिक्स वील हैव इक्वालिटी एंड सोशल इकोनॉमिक लाइफ we will have inequality. We must remove this contradiction at the earliest possible moment or else those who suffer from inequality will blow up the structure of political democracy which this assembly has so laboriously built up. Well said, Dr. Ambedkar. Atah yah brahattar samaj ka punit samvidhanik kartavya hai ki vikas samavesh aur sarvasparshi ho. विकास समावेशी और सर्वस्पर्शी हो. दीनदयाल जी का अंत्योदय के परिकल्पना और नानाजी के ग्रामीण स्वावलंबन के प्रयास इसी आदर्श से प्रेरित है. द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इंटीग्रल ह्यूमनिज्म ऑफ पंडित दीनदयाल उपाध्याय एंड इट्स एप्लीकेबिलिटी ऑन द ग्राउंड बाय नानाजी देशमुख क्लियरली डेमोन्स्ट्रेट द पैरामेंट रोल ऑफ द people in the development of the country. People must have a role. Otherwise, nothing will succeed. Nothing will transform. Nanaji placed the people at the center of development and wanted society to take the lead. He believed in collective responsibility and collective efforts to transform rural areas into thriving hubs of economic activities. In a way, he was the pioneer of the present-day corporate social responsibility and had in those days inspired many industrialists to contribute towards social cause. Aaj bhi hum log dekh rahe hain samaj mein kuch log aisa sochte hain sab kaam sarkar karega hum bekar baithe to chalega. Aisa nahi chalega. Aisa nahi chalega. Anubhav yahi bata rahe. Isliye Pradhanmantri ji ne bhi jab Swachh Bharat beti bachao beti padhao और आदि कार्यक्रमों का उन्होंने घोषणा किया, शुभारंभ किया, उस समय उन्होंने बताया कि केवल राजनीतिक कार्यक्रम नहीं होना चाहिए, सरकारी कार्यक्रम नहीं होना चाहिए, एक जन आंदोलन का रूप देना चाहिए. जब तक ऐसी मूवमेंट जन आंदोलन नहीं बनेंगे, ये आपका जो लक्ष्य और लक्ष्य पहुंचना आसान नहीं होगा. ये हमारा अनुभव बता रहे. फ्रेंड्स, द टाइम हैज कम फॉर अस टू थिंक रीथिंक गवर्नेंस. वी हैव अ यूनिक अपॉर्चुनिटी टुडे. वाइड रेंजिंग फॉर रीचिंग रिफॉर्म्स आर ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग अवर कंट्री. द प्राइम मिनिस्टर सेड रिफॉर्म परफॉर्म एंड ट्रांसफॉर्म. ट्रांसफॉर्म द नेशन. Transformation. They are not simple words. People are eagerly looking for new modes of service delivery. They are not content with being passive recipients of the fruits of development. They would like to be active change agents. They wish to plant new trees for the future growth of the country. We must make this positive energy, collective will and aspirational idealism work for national development. Fortunately, 65% of the Indian population is below 35 years. These youngsters are aspirational. They are now blessed with those noble thoughts of developing integrated approach. Bharat ka sarvangina unnati chahiye unko. Sarvangina unnati, few five-star hotels, or few national highways, few metro trains, or few other big achievements alone will not suffice. Every human being in the country must feel that is also part of the system, that is also part of the development of story, that is the mood of the people. Samaj mein jo antim pankti mein baithe hai, unka uttan ko pahli pradhamikata dena chahiye. दीनदयाल जी का सिद्धांत, नाना जी का सिद्धांत यही है. हम लोग सब उसी में विश्वास करना चाहिए. वी मस्ट मेक दिस पॉजिटिव एनर्जी, करेक्टिव विल एंड एस्पिरेशन आइडियलिज्म वर्क फॉर नेशनल डेवलपमेंट. प्रेजेंट गवर्नमेंट स्वच्छ भारत प्रोग्राम इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ पीपुल्स पार्टिसिपेशन इन ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग द नेशन. स्वच्छ भारत हैज नाउ बिकम ए पीपुल्स मूवमेंट एंड कंट्रीब्यूटिंग ह्यूजली इन चेंजिंग द माइंड सेट ऑफ द मासेस. From celebrities to common man, that today, even after 70 years of independence, the country is facing various challenges like poverty. 25% of the people, or 21% are below poverty line. Illiteracy, 22% of the people of the country, after 70 years of independence, they can't read, they can't write. Lack of skills among the youth. We have the youth, we have graduates, but there are no enough skills. And urban-rural divide, to name a few. Collective efforts are needed to overcome these challenges, and the people should be in the forefront of complementing the initiatives of the government. In fact, Constitution lists several fundamental duties of the citizens, and one of them is to strive towards excellence in all spheres of individual and collective activity, so that the nation constantly rises to higher level of endeavor and achievements. For deepening the roots of democracy and strengthening pluralism, it is important for the people across the social strata to contribute in a conscious manner towards building an egalitarian, healthy, inclusive and responsive society. Progress can be achieved only when there is peace, social, communal and cultural harmony. I always say peace is the prerequisite for progress. And if there is tension, there cannot be attention towards development. We are aware of the many factors that can create divisions among the people: caste, religion, region and language and many others. Unfortunately, these things are now trying to dominate the minds of the people in certain segments. We should all raise above these narrow considerations. I always feel an advocate with my own experience of 45 years of public life. Selection and election should be on the basis of character, caliber, capacity and conduct, not on the basis of caste, community, cash and criminality, which are trying to influence the society, which are influencing certain areas. We can't deny it. We politicians may not agree, no, everything is and all, but we know it. Caste, community, cash and criminality are influencing certain nations in certain places. This is a very, very negative development. We have to nip it in the bud. We must raise above this. And then Dindalji said once, he said, vote for the candidate based on his character and his capacity. And he said, not only that, but once you are satisfied, then see his party, his philosophy and programs. He said, if party and philosophy and programs are good, then look at the person, his character, caliber, capacity and conduct. Character, caliber, capacity and good, then look into programs and policies. Intelligently, in a simple manner, he has put it at that time. So we have to see both and balance both. Both are also equally important. It is high time for us to find a cause that can bind us together, make us work as Team India. And that cause is not hard to find. In fact, number of challenges continue to stare us in our face. If we can reform our governance pattern, we can transform our lives. If we can focus on output and outcomes, if we can avoid wasting our energies and precious resources on unproductive, counterproductive actions, if we can collaborate rather than confront, if we can think of pooling our individual strength, we can fast-track development. This is very important. The government creates an enabling framework, provides infrastructure, sets the pace, monitors the quality, and encourages public participation. The civil society has a critical role to play in societal transformation, in heightening awareness, changing the behavior and attitudes to achieve a better quality of life. Dear sisters and brothers, the country needs selfless leaders like Nanaji Deshmukh at a grassroots level to inspire and empower each citizen to become a proud partner in India's progress. Deshmukh ji jaise karma yogi, dhanya jeevi, yadi kaam karte rahenge to desh ka mukhachitra, desh ka mukhachitra badal jayega. Aur naya saksham Bharat ubarega. Deshmukh, bahumukh, pragnashali. वो देश का मुखचित्र बदलना चाहते थे, इसलिए उन्होंने ग्रासरूट लेवल में काम करना शुरू किया. Inspired by Nanaji's illustrious example, I have been actively associated with Swarna Bharat Trust, a voluntary organization dedicated to the welfare of the youth, farmers and women. I get regenerated every time I visit the remarkable social service institution. I have been to Chitrakoot. I spent a considerable time with Nanaji. And I was so inspired by the grassroots level work he was doing in a remote area where there is no airport, where there is no proper railway station, where it is not a junction, though it's part of Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh together and remote. The transformation he brought in the 500 villages, that has really inspired me. And in fact, I must tell you today, I can share it as special. Occasion, I will come to it a little later. As we talk of late Nanaji Deshmukh and late Pandit Dindal Upadhyay ji, it would be an honor to know how their vision, philosophy and their of India has evolved and how they were inspired to rededicate themselves to the cause of the society and the nation. I think it is essentially their strong nationalistic fervor and idealism which distinguished them from many other leaders. Their passion has its roots in Rashtriya Swayamsevaka Sangh and its ideological moorings. This world's largest voluntary missionary organization has attracted all those who put everything country above everything else, like Nanaji Deshmukh, Dindal Upadhyaya, and many others. Even Mahatma Gandhiji has acknowledged the positive values proponed by RSS in 1934, Bapu said, and I quote, "When I visited the RSS camp, I was very much surprised by your discipline and the absence of untouchability," he wrote. He personally inquired about this to Swayamsevaks who were sitting next to him while taking lunch. He inquired about their community. To his surprise, he found that they are not bothered about each other's caste. My own initiation into public life was through RSS. This organization taught me a lot about life, values, our culture, our heritage, and the nation, and my duties to the nation and fellow citizens. It offered me a perspective of humanity, a sense of purpose for life, and a framework for positive action. Like me, thousands have spent a lifetime in public life. I feel proud of my association with RSS. Even I said it on the floor of the parliament also, when I was there as a minister. Even now, I have no hesitation in saying it publicly. What I am today is because of the training I had in the initial days, either in RSS or RSS-inspired ABVP. From my association with RSS, I can assure you, my friends, that all that RSS is all about self-discipline, self-respect, self-defense, self-reliance, self-respect, self-defense, self-reliance, social reform, social consciousness, social movement, selfless service, all guided by the philosophy of supremacy of the nation. I see no reason for anyone to have any objection to these principles, which are primarily aimed at character development, based on core ancient Indian ethos and values, which advocated the philosophy of Vasudhaiva Kutumbam, meaning the whole world is one family. Late Jay Prakash Narayanji said of RSS in 1977, and I quote, RSS alone has the capacity to transform society and casteism and wipe the tears from the eyes of the poor. I have great expectations from this revolutionary organization which has taken up the challenge of creating a new India. This is what JP said. JP was initially, because of initial socialist background, he was a critic of RSS. When he came closer, when he understood and he saw their contribution, then this is the remark he has made. Friends, I was telling about my own inspiration of from Nanaji. In fact, having been minister, having been MLA, having been state general secretary, having been national general secretary, having been MLA, having been leader of the party in assembly, having been member of parliament for more than 18 years, now 20, and having been general secretary at the national level, having been the spokesperson, having been the president of the ruling party at the center, and then again becoming a minister, both for rural development and then for urban development, I was of the opinion that I must quit politics and take up the social work. That was my conviction after I complete 70 years of age. So I was calculating accordingly. By 2019, I'll be reaching 70. So I should give up, because Nanaji Deshmukh, he was basically a Sangha Pracharak, then he was Janasangh leader or India General Secretary, then he was in the forefront of Chhatra Sangharsha Samiti, started by Jay Prakash Narayan to fight against tyranny, autocracy, and then he, as Tavarchandji has said, he protected JP from the attack of the police, where he broke his hand also. And then the real story begins. He just mentioned it. After emergency, elections came, 1977. Even I contested election as a student leader, right from the jail. Because of JP, youth were preferred in every state. I was asked to contest one Lok Sabha seat. So JP asked Nanaji also to contest. He was reluctant. But finally, bowing to the wish of JP, he contested from Balrampur, present-day Gonda, of Uttar Pradesh, and got elected to Lok Sabha. And then, at that time, this Janata Party, I'm talking of history, I'm not talking politics, because I'm no more connected with politics now. Janasangh, Swatantra Party, Socialist Party, Old Congress, they all formed Janata Party. And in the elections, Moraji Bhai became leader of the Janata Party and became the Prime Minister. Then from the all these parties came together from the Janasangh segment, Sri Atal Bihari Vajpayee, Sri Lal Krishna Advani, and Sri Nanaji Deshmukh. They were chosen by Moraji Desai to be in his cabinet. So Nanaji told Moraji Bhai, I don't want to join the cabinet. And he was offered an important portfolio of industries. Industry portfolio is not that much important now because you don't have license Raj, permit Raj, and all those days, industry portfolio was one of the most important portfolios. Most of the people used to be after that. So Nanaji told Moraji Bhai, no, after a particular age, one must leave position and go to society and do some grassroots level work. I was so much impressed by his thought. Because, after all, as I said, we are a young nation. Youngsters has to be given opportunity. So I was myself, nobody compelled me. And nobody even asked me also. I was myself thinking, okay, enough of it. Coming from an ordinary agriculture background, son of an humble farmer, come to this level, enjoyed all these responsibilities. So, okay, say then bye and go to social work. And I decided the date also, January 12th, Sankranti Day, 2019. That was my 2020, because 19 I'll be completing 70, and then the new government will be formed and then leave the politics. And then go to social work and do more constructive. I don't say politics are not constructive, though some of them are not. Obstructive, destructive, constructive, restrictive, all these things we are seeing nowadays. Various shades are there in politics. So I was of the opinion and I shared my thoughts with few of my colleagues. First I briefed my wife. I convinced her also because, you know, at the height of your popularity, leaving and withdrawing from politics, people can't even imagine about it. But I was so inspired by his actions. And I told my wife, she said, fine. And then I told Prime Minister Narendra Bhai Modi. Not once, twice. So when third time I was mentioning to him, he said, Venkaiah ji, 2019 hai na? ये तो मैंने पहले बात किया उनसे 2017 में तो उन्होंने कहा है तो अभी 16-17 है आगे है देखेंगे तब तो बट यू नो द सर्कमस्टेंसेस ऑफ कोर्स वन विश इज फुलफिल्ड दैट आई एम आउट ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स आई नो मोर बिलोंग टू थावरचंद गहलोत्स पार्टी और एनी पार्टी फॉर दैट मैटर बट आई हैव बीन सेलेक्टेड एंड इलेक्टेड टू ए कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी Because you need to bring change at the grassroots level. You need to motivate the people to participate in development and governance. You need to take up the cause of the people at the grassroots level. That is very important. And this is what Nanaji has did. And he refused to become a minister. When he was General Secretary of the Chhatra Sangharsh Samiti, he was General Secretary of the newly formed Janata Party. And then he quit politics. And then went and started doing this work, voluntary work, and motivate people. Nanaji's personality was such that a lot of people came to support him also even to. So I, inspired by the thoughts, I told my friends, let us join together, do some social work and voluntary work. Then that idea of Swarna Bharat came and for the last 17 years we've been working on that. And I must tell you friends, in spite of my busy schedule as a minister, as the ruling party president, I used to go once in every month to visit that voluntary organization, spend time there, join the service activity and used to get rejuvenated. I am using the word consciously. Rejuvenated of my determination in spite of political ups and downs, challenges, etc. I go there and I used to spend time and work with the volunteers. I used to feel rejuvenated. Get further inspiration. That's how the work, because my grandfather told me, if you do your responsibility, it will give you happiness. If you do beyond your responsibility, then it will give you utmost happiness. उन्होंने अपना भाषा में कहा ये काम करे तो अपना काम दायित्व निभाए तो आपको आनंद मिलेगा आप अपना दायित्व से आगे बढ़कर, माने दायित्व माने एमपी मीन्स हैज डू हिज ड्यूटी, मिनिस्टर हैज टू डू हिज ड्यूटी, देयर इज नथिंग ग्रेट. ऑफ कोर्स दो दी रिसेंटली प्राइम मिनिस्टर सेड डूइंग देयर ड्यूटी इज बेस्ट पेट्रियाटिज्म. देशभक्ति का उन्होंने कार्य दिया, हर एक व्यक्ति अपना काम करे वो देशभक्ति है. माने कुछ लोग कर नहीं कर रहे ना, वो भी इफ एवरीबडी एट एवरी लेवल डज देयर वर्क देन दैट इज पेट्रियाटिज्म, दैट इज देशभक्ति. आई विल कम टू इट लेटर बिफोर आई कंक्लूड. सो I really, and my grandfather told, if you go beyond your duty, then it will give you, पहले वाले आपको आनंद देता है, मगर दूसरा वाले आपको महदानंद देता है. That's, I really feel, used to feel, enjoy. Now as a vice president, there are some problems, but still, I am trying to visit those voluntary organizations, and then without any help from the government, working at the grassroots level. This is very much required because of India's size, huge country, 130 crore people, then 760 languages, and then different regions, and then 20 to 23% poverty, 22% illiteracy, then social discrimination of some sections of even today after 70 years of independence. We try, politicians are trying to score this thing, aapka zamana mein itna hua, mera zamana mein itna kam hua, aur mahilaon ke upar atyachar, ye atyachar hai to ये बुराई है, इसको समाप्त करना है. उसको द मूवमेंट यू पोलिटिकलाइज दैट द कॉज इज लॉस्ट. द मूवमेंट यू पोलिटिकलाइज एनी डिस्क्रिमिनेशन ऑन द बेस ऑफ कैस्ट, द मूवमेंट यू पोलिटिकलाइज एनी डिस्क्रिमिनेशन ऑन द बेस ऑफ रिलीजियन, द मूवमेंट यू अट्रीब्यूट पॉलिटिक्स टू सोशल डिस्क्रिमिनेशन, देन द कॉज इज लॉस्ट. दैट्स हाउ इज बींग लॉस्ट. ऑल दीज इयर्स पोलिटिकल पार्टीज आर कंप्यूटिंग ईच अदर ब्लेम. आपका जमाने में इतना रेप हुआ, मेरा जमाने में कम हुआ, उससे कोई मतलब नहीं है. So these things cannot be changed simply by legislations. I am of the view, I said it from the floor of the parliament also. People, there was a clamor for a Nirbhaya Act, the aftermath of that shameful incident, horrible, of an act, bill, new bill. I said on the floor of the parliament, I repeat, mere bill will not suffice. What is required is political will, administrative skill, and go for the kill of the evil. समाज में चेतना, समाज में जागृत आना चाहिए, देन माइंड सेट में परिवर्तन आना चाहिए, तभी यह संभव होगा. अदरवाइज वॉट इज दिस अट्रोशियस, फोर ईयर चाइल्ड बींग रेप्ड, सिक्स ईयर चाइल्ड बींग रेप्ड, टीचर रेपिंग स्टूडेंट, एंड स्टूडेंट्स अटैकिंग टीचर इन सम प्लेसेस. वॉट इज हैपनिंग? वॉट हैज बीन अवर कल्चर? वॉट हैज बीन अवर ट्रेडिशन? हाउ यूज टू रेस्पेक्ट वुमन? वी कॉल दिस कंट्री ऑल्सो मदर लैंड, नॉट फादर्स लैंड. भारत माता. And many of the rivers in the country are named after women. Narmada, Tapati, Mahendra Tanaya, Kaveri, Yamuna, Saraswati, Ganga. Oh, many. That is the respect we used to give to women. And now, with this incidents. So they are a challenge to society. Challenge can be met, one, of course, by legislations. Second is by creating awareness among the people, motivating the people, changing the mindset of the people. That is very much important, changing the mindset for everything. I remember that Bill Gates met me when I was minister, when I was launching a Swachh Bharat program. He told me, Mr. Naidu, issue is not money, issue is of mindset mostly, he said. Yeah, I realize it. It's true. You have to change the mindset, and slowly mindset is changing. We have to move in that direction. Secondly, I want to tell, because I was talking about RSS, RSS means ready for selfless service. Creating discipline, making you realize full potential of your life, making you physically fit. All these things are very much required for a dynamic nation. And then nationalism, patriotism, that's also debate is on. I want to focus on that and then conclude. What is patriotism? देशभक्ति माने क्या है? भारत माता चित्रपट को माला लगा के भारत माता को जय कहने से वो देशभक्ति होता है क्या? और वंदे मातरम कहने से देशभक्त होता है क्या? जरूरी है, सिंबॉलिक है, मगर असली देशभक्ति तभी होगा देश में सभी लोगों के बारे में आप सोचे, उनका हित के लिए कुछ करे, then that is the real Deshbhakti. You cannot claim that you are a patriot by hating other person, other citizen, by discriminate other citizen on the basis of caste, a religion, a region. Vividhata mein ekata, Bharat ka visheshata, alag bhasha, alag vesh, phir bhi apna ek desh. Irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, India is one. We are one nation. Anything happening to Kashmir, everybody should get disturbed, agitated. Anything happening in Arunachal Pradesh, everybody, even in Kutch or even in Kanyakumari, should be concerned. That is patriotism. Do something what you can do. Respecting the national flag, respecting the army, respecting the Bharat Mata photo, standing up during Vande Mataram or Janaganamana, symbolic. But the real patriotism, real Deshbhakti is concerned about all in the country. So, kabhi kabhi hum log Rama Rajya ke baare mein baat karte hain na. Rama Rajya maane kya hai? Jahan bhook nahi, bhrashtachar nahi hai, bhedbhav nahi hai. That is Rama Rajya ideal. That's why Mahatma Gandhi said, let us have Rama Rajya. And unhone ye bhi kaha, Rama Rajya ke bina Rama Rajya adhura hai, aisa kaha. He underscored the importance of rural development. So this has to be understood by all people. Whoever is talking about patriotism or Deshbhakti or nationalism should think in terms of thinking about everybody. Nobody should be left without food, without clothes, without care. Because share and care is the basic philosophy of India. Share and care is the basic philosophy of India. The life of Dindayalji, life of Nanaji Deshmukh, this is the message. Work for the people. Work among the people. Work with the people. Work through the people. This is the message of his life. So we should really, can we go for this Vyakhyanamala or can we pay tribute to the great souls? Unka pravachan kya hai? Unka margadarshan kya hai? Wo margadarshan ko hum log hamara niji jeevan mein usko amal karne ke liye prayas kare, wahi sahi shraddhanjali hoga. Simply garlanding, simply celebrating is not a real tribute. The real tribute is following him, following good things which you like in him, good things. You may differ on certain issues, but at the same time there is a great area where you can take inspiration and work. This is what is our this thing. See, I told you about Jayaprakash's feelings. I told you about Gandhiji's feelings. I have many, right from Inobhava onwards, many people who were impressed by the good work done. So this Dindayalji and Nanaji, their inspiration was because of the early childhood of their life being influenced by the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh. The Dindayal Research Institute, started in 1968, is doing a wonderful job, and I hope that it will further expand its activities and motivate people and involve people in the country, because as I told you, challenges are many, new challenges are coming, and then at the same time new opportunities also there. We are living in an era of LPG, liberalization, privatization, globalization. So world is moving faster and India cannot afford to be lagging behind. Fortunately, India is also on the move. You have the reports of the World Bank, you have the reports of the Economic Forum, you have the reports of ADB, you have the reports of ratings, so many ratings and all, which are saying India has got a bright future. Whether it is GDP, whether it is technology, whether it is, oh, in every front, India is moving. We have wisdom. We have skills in our generations. Because this land, this air, this water has given us that strength and that wisdom. See, world over, multinational companies are being led by Indians. Many of the companies. The talent. You have such a talent. What is required is little upgradation of the skill. Even the ordinary people, the goldsmith, the blacksmith, even the washerman, the cook, or the driver, everyone has got some skill or other. Just upgrade the skills. This is where institutions like Dindayalji Swasthan, institutions like other voluntary organizations are focusing, and they should focus much more to upgrade the skills of the people, particularly women, particularly rural farmers, particularly youth. These are the three core sectors that has to be focused and concentrated upon. So friends, as I told you, we are living in a aspirational India. Each one of us has a responsibility. We must all get the inspiration from see Nanaji Deshmukh, of the way he lived such a simple life, simple. I had the opportunity of meeting him at an early age, and I was in college. He came to my town, and I was instrumental as a worker, karyakarta, to organize a stage for his meetings. Those days, the stage construction used to be around 50-60 rupees. Stage expenditure. Everything, do it voluntarily, don't give it to others. That's how those early days used to be. Now, of course, it has become outsourcing for the political parties also. Outsourcing, leaving the main source. I remember those days, how he used to guide, he used to be very punctual, he used to be very disciplined. He used to be intolerant towards indiscipline. So I feel that the privilege is given to me to come here to this function and give this Nanaji Memorial Lecture. Thank you very much for the opportunity given, and also I hope in the future also this samstha, this organization will expand its activities further and take the country forward and try to bridge the urban-rural divide and motivate the people to be part of the development. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.